the peaceful coexistence of our species and other species has been a passion of mine for my career. I'm absolutely thrilled that I'm the 2019 winner of the International Cosmos Prize. It's a prize that celebrates the coexistence of nature and humankind. I'd like to think that the reason I got this prize is because I view science in a very effective way to recommend practical conservation actions. There's a lot of good science out there that's interesting and it's important, but it isn't immediately actionable. And one of the things that I'm very proud that I've been able to do here at the Nicholas School at Duke University is develop this program of developing science that can make an actual difference to whether species survive or not. Years ago, I founded an organization called Saving Species, and it grew remarkably quickly. We have reformed ourselves in terms of saving nature, and it's dedicated to helping communities and conservation professionals around the world, typically in developing countries that are very rich in biodiversity, Colombia and Ecuador and Brazil and India and Sumatra, places where there are a lot of species at risk of extinction. And we're there to help those local groups do what they can to help preserve nature and help the people who live in those communities have sustainable lives, help them have better lives that are compatible with the coexistence of nature and humankind.
Even after sometimes a few years, there is enough forest coming back that a wonderful variety of birds and mammals, otters and foxes and pheasants and pitters, a whole variety of species are moving through the corridors that we have recreated.
I think the challenge of this new century, this new millennium, is whether we are going to continue to destroy the planet in the way that we have done, or recognize that we can make some smart changes. We do not need to destroy tropical forests. We do not need to be careless with how much pollution that we put into our rivers and into the oceans. We do not need to put billions and billions of tons of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere each year. I think my contribution has to bring cutting-edge science and technology into the very practical aspect of saving species from extinction. There are particular places in the world, the northern Andes, coastal Brazil, Madagascar, Southeast Asia, where there are places that just have enormous number of species that are sort of hanging on by their fingernails. I'm proud of the fact that we can go from satellite imagery through quite complicated statistical analysis and mapping right down to the point where I decide that I'm going to dig a hole and I'm going to plant a tree right there because that's the best place to regrow a forest, to re-establish connectivity, to save biodiversity.